My name's Guybrush Threepwood, and I want to be a pirate.
Yikes! Don't sneak up on me like that.
I'm over this way.
Ah, well then, Thriftweed.
Threepwood. Guybrush Threepwood.
I see. So, you want to be a pirate, eh? You look more like a flooring inspector. But if you're serious about pirating, go talk to the pirate leaders. You'll find them in the scum bar.
Gosh, thanks. I'll do that. Bye now. I'm off to seek my fortune.
Good luck.
Where did you say those pirate leaders were?
The scum bar.
Right. Thanks. Re-elect Governor Marley. When there's only one candidate, there's only one choice.
What be ye wanting, boy?
I want to be a pirate.
So what? Why bother us?
Hey, don't forget we're short on help because of this whole LeChuck thing. So, no pirates means no swag, and no swag means no grog, and we're getting dangerously low on grog.
Do you have any special skills?
I can hold my breath for 10 minutes.
Well, all right, but you don't become a pirate just by asking.
You'll have to go through
the three trials.
What three trials are those?
There are three trials every pirate must pass.
He must master the sword.
And the art of thievery.
And the quest.
The what?
Treasure hunting, you sea urchin. Right. You must prove yourself in each of these three areas. Swordplay, thievery, and the treasure huntery. Then return with proof that you've done it.
And then you must drink grog with us.
Grog!
Tell me more about treasure hunting.
Legend has it that there's a treasure buried here on the island.
All you must do is find the legendary lost treasure of Melee Island and bring it back here.
Should I have a map or something?
Well, you can hardly expect to find a treasure without a map.
And don't forget, X marks the spot!
Tell me more about mastering the sword.
First, get ye a sword. You must seek out and defeat the sword master. Someone in town can probably direct you. Oh! You want to find somebody to train you first.
Imagine trying to take on the sword master without any training.
Tell me more about mastering the art of thievery.
We want you to procure a small item for us.
The idol of many hands.
In the governor's mansion.
The governor keeps the idol of many hands in a display case in the mansion outside the town.
You'll have to get past the guards, naturally.
The tricky part will be getting past the dogs outside.
Hey, they're a particularly vicious breed. They might be able to drug him or something.
What's in that grog stuff anyway?
Grog is a secret mixture which contains one or more of the following.
Kerosene.
Propylene glycol.
Artificial sweeteners.
Sulfuric acid.
Rum.
Acetone.
Red dye number 2.
Scum.
Axle grease. Battery acid.
And or pepperoni. As you can probably imagine, it's one of the most caustic, volatile substances known to man.
The stuff eats right through these mugs, and the cook is losing a fortune replacing them.
I'll just be running along now.
Leave us to our grog.
Come back later and tell us how you're doing.
Hey, you can't come back here.
Meanwhile, deep beneath Monkey Island, the ghost pirate LeChuck's ship lies anchored in a river of lava.
Captain LeChuck, sir,
there's nothing like the hot winds of hell blowing in your face.
No, sir, nothing like it. Sir,
it's days like this that make you glad to be dead.
Oh, yes, sir. Glad to be dead.
You are glad to be dead, right?
Oh, yes, sir. I feel so lucky that you happened to capture my ship, then murdered me and everyone on board. Yes, sir. Lucky.
Glad to hear it. Now, what was it you disturbed me for?
Yes, sir. Well, you see, we might have a problem on Melee Island.
Problem? What possible problem could there be? I've got those sissy pirates so scared of the sea, they're afraid to take a bath.
Well, there seems to be a new pirate in town. Actually, he's a pirate wannabe. Young, inexperienced, probably nothing to worry about. Don't know why I bothered you with it. I've taken care of myself.
Wait! I'll handle this personally. My plans are too important to be messed up by amateurs.
Yes, sir.
I get in the cannon, but the gunpowder makes me sneeze.
Well, I can't do it. I hurt my hand taming the lions last week.
I hardly think that little scratch compares to my chronic allergy. You get in the cannon.
You don't have any allergies, you faker. You get in the cannon.
No, you get in the cannon.
No, you get in the cannon.
Slacker.
Loser.
Ruffian.
Fop.
Weasel.
Weevil.
Say there, son, how'd you like the chance?
A once-in-a-lifetime chance.
To perform an amazing feat.
A death-defying feat?
Well, not so death-defying, really.
Dangerous feat?
No, not dangerous at all.
An easy feat.
But exciting.
With the amazing.
Adventurous. Acrobatic.
And exceedingly well-known.
Fabulous. Flying!
Ferrucini Brothers!
That's us!
My brother Alfredo.
And my brother Bill.
Sound good?
Good.
It's very simple, really.
See that cannon over there? All you have to do
is get in the cannon.
And we'll shoot you out of it.
Across the room.
Quite safe, actually.
So, what do you say?
How much will you pay me?
How about 478 pieces of eight?
Okay, sounds good.
Have you got a helmet?
No, I don't have a helmet. Will I need one?
No helmet?
Oh, you've got to have a helmet.
Can't do the cannon trick without a helmet.
No, sirree.
Go get a helmet and then we can do the trick.
Weasel.
Weevil.
Miscreant.
Tony.
Hello again.
Ready to do the cannon trick?
Have you got a helmet?
Of course I have a helmet. What sort of idiot do you take me for?
Well, let's have it.
We want to be sure.
That it's safe.
Wouldn't want you hurt.
No, sorry. Ah, that will work as a helmet.
Now we can do the trick.
Step right over here, son.
Now, put on your helmet.
And get in the cannon.
And we'll take care of the rest.
Echo!
Echo!
It works!
Oh, I'm so relieved.
Hey!
Are you okay?
Where's my helmet?
It's all right!
Hooray! We are spared an embarrassing and a financially debilitating lawsuit.
Here is your money, sir.
Just a recompense for aiding us.
The basic theory is fine.
We just need to change the aim a bit.
I'll try it next.
No, I'll do it next.
No, me!
No, me!
Slacker.
Loser.
Ruffian.
Fop.
Excuse me, but do you have a cousin named Sven?
No, but I once had a barber named Dominique.
Close enough. Let's talk business. You want to buy a map to the legendary lost treasure of Melee Island? Only one in existence. Rare. Very rare. Only 100 pieces of eight.
I'll take it. It'll make a swell gift.
There you go. You made a wise decision. Now get lost.
Maybe no one will miss just this one thing.
What may I help you with, son? Wait. Don't say anything. I can sense your name is Guybrush. Guybrush Nosehair. No. Threepwood. Guybrush Threepwood. Am I not right?
Wow, that was amazing. Do you know any other tricks?
I do not deal in tricks. What I know is the truth. Ah, I sense the guilt of stealing my chicken grows. Take it. It's yours.
Why don't you want it? Is it jinxed with an ancient voodoo curse?
No. The pulley squeaks. I can tell you grow tired. Go, please.
Get me out of here! I'm a victim of society!
Not to mention halitosis. Ugh.
Hey, it's hard to keep my breath minty fresh when there's nothing to eat in here but rats.
Hello? Anybody in here? Hello?
You know, bad things could happen to a person in a dark, deserted alley like this one. And at this time of night, nobody would be around to see it.
Did you hear something back in here, too?
No. I'd better get your name.
I'm Guybrush Threepwood, and I'm a mighty pirate.
Listen, Peepwood.
Threepwood. Guybrush Threepwood.
Well, whatever your name is, listen. I'm the sheriff around here. Sheriff Fester Shinetop. Take it from me. This is a bad time to be visiting Melee Island. A very bad time. My advice to you is to find somewhere else to take your vacation. Somewhere safer.
Boy, I feel much better knowing there's an officer of the law around. Employees only.
It never fails. I step away from the counter for 2 seconds and some idiot's already ringing that stupid bell. What do you want?
About this sword.
Yeah, what about it?
I want it.
Great. Best 100 pieces of eight you ever spent. What else do you want?
About this shovel.
Yeah, what about it?
I want it.
Great. Oh, it'll pay for itself, believe me. Yeah, you'll dig up 75 pieces of eight in no time. But hey, save some treasure for the rest of us, would you? What else do you want?
I could really use a breath mint.
Whew, you're telling me. Here, take one, please. Take the whole roll. That'll be 1 piece of 8. What else do you want?
I'm looking for the Swordmaster of Melee Island.
The Swordmaster of Melee Island? Now, I don't know. See, nobody knows the whereabouts of her secret hideout. Nobody except me. I'd have to go and ask her if it's okay to show you the way. I guess I could hike all the way over there. Once. Be right back. And don't touch anything!
Thank you.
I better just stay back here and eavesdrop.
Hello again, Carla.
I thought I told you to get lost.
Actually, I'm here on business. This kid come into my store, see?
Face it, you crusty old lech. You'd make any excuse just to come out here and bother me.
Yeah, I guess so.
Well, cut it out. I'm sick of it. Take a hike and don't come out here again. Someone might follow you, and then I'd become another Melee Island tourist attraction.
Hey, it's your loss, baby.
Yeah, right. Now scram.
Whatever you wantin', you scurvy lubber?
Sorry to bother you. I'll be on my way. I don't think I can get past them.
Important notice. These dogs are not dead. They are only sleeping. No animals were harmed during the production of this game.
This looks like a job for Fester Shinetop.
Better leave this here.
No, not the red button.
It's a big, ugly, hairy yak wearing some wax lips. I can't move it. I can't move it. I'll need this. I must be nuts.
Heck! Gophers!
Beautiful. I can't open it.
Uh-oh.
That should hold him for a while.
If only I had a file, I could get the idol.
Grago Mint! How refreshing! Thanks! So, have you come to release me?
Would you happen to have a file?
You think I'd be in here if I did? All I have is this carrot cake my Aunt Tilly made me. You can have that if you bring me something to get rid of these rats! I can't stand carrot cake! Hey! This might work on the rats.
Thanks.
Here's the cake.
I've got the file.
That was a close one. At least I got the idol.
But I'm not done with you yet.
Uh-oh.
Thought you could get out of here with the idol of many hands, did you?
Look, I can explain.
So can I. You poisoned the governor's pet poodles.
They're just sleeping.
Broke into her house.
The door was unlocked.
And stole one of her most valuable pieces of art.
No, you've got it all wrong.
Oh, really? Well, let's hear your explanation.
It belongs in a museum.
Ta!
What's going on here?
I caught this hoodlum making off with your idol, Governor. He says it belongs in a museum.
That's right, it does.
What?
You heard me, Fester. The real question is, how did he get in here while you were on guard? Oh, just go away, Fester. I can handle this.
I'll deal with you later.
Sorry about him. He's new. I'm Governor Marley. Governor Elaine Marley. So my idol belongs in a museum, eh? Relax, Mr. Threepwood. I know why you're here. Believe me, you're not the first who's tried. Although I have to admit, not many get as far as you have. My lookout told me of your arrival. I've wanted to meet you ever since I heard your fascinating name. Tell me, Guybrush, why do you want to be a pirate? You don't look like one. Your face is too... sweet.
Boof.
I see. Well, you're obviously not in the mood for idle chit-chat, are you? I suppose you've got many more exciting things to do. I won't take up any more of your time, Mr. Threepwood.
Boo! Murfinkiv! Gringly?
I really wish I knew how to talk to women.
Where do you think you're going, Froom Wade?
I'm going to go put this idol in my safe deposit box.
Oh, really? I know a really safe locker you could put it in. Davy Jones locker. Hand over your sword.
Uh-oh.
This is the end of the road, my little pantalooned pal. Your troublemaking days on Melee Island are over. My plans for the governor are far too important and much too near completion to risk letting a would-be pirate like you get in the way. So long, Mr. Spicecake, or Droopface, or whatever your name is. This might actually turn out to be a pretty good day.
I guess I'll be needing a sword. This one will do. Well, that wasn't so hard. Now all I have to do is show this stupid idol to the pirate leaders and...
You're alive!
Governor!
Hey, you can talk. Huh, who'd have known?
What are you doing here? Come to finish the job?
No, I came down here to save your life. Fester wasn't acting on my orders when he threw you in there.
You came down here to rescue me? I didn't even think you liked me.
Well, our first meeting was a little awkward. You seemed to have trouble forming complete sentences. But then again, so do most of my citizens.
But I'm not one of your citizens. I'm just a drifter. A nobody. A would-be pirate. Who would have known or even cared if you'd let me drown?
I would have, Guybrush.
Oh, Governor.
Oh, Threepwood.
Oh, Elaine.
Oh, Guybrush.
Love Muffin.
Sugar Boots.
Honey Pumpkin.
Plunder Bunny.
Kiss me.
No, we mustn't.
What?
Not here, where everyone can see us.
Why? Are you ashamed of me?
No, it's not that at all. It's just that many of these pirates have made advances towards me, and to avoid hurting their feelings, I've always told them that my father made me promise never to fall in love with a pirate. If they see us together, they'll know I was lying.
Okay, then. Let's go to your place.
Okay. But finish your trials first. I don't want you to be preoccupied.
But... I feel this sudden urge to complete the trials quickly. It's my little plunder bunny. I've been had. This is no map. It looks like dancing lessons. The legendary lost treasure of Melee Island. This carefully reproduced piece of Melee Island history has delighted thousands of would-be pirates and their families for generations. Remember, there are other pirates on this island, so go easy on the treasure. Leave some for the next person. Here lies treasure of such unimaginable wealth. Well, you'll just have to dig it up to believe it. Paid for by the Melee Island Chamber of Commerce. Well, this shouldn't take too long.
Hours pass.
Hey, I think I hit something. Oh boy! It's a t-shirt! Not my size, but a nice one nonetheless. Well, I guess I should put all this dirt back now.
More hours pass.
Pay a toll.
Oh, please, can't I pass?
Oh, boy, do you sound like a wimp. I don't like wimps.
None shall pass.
Ah, a red herring.
Pass.
Captain Smirk's Big Body Pirate Gym. Prices. Sword training, 30 pieces of weight. Cannon firing, 160 pieces of weight. Balls extra. Grappling hook, 130 pieces of weight. Hook extra. I think I'll knock. It'd only be polite.
What do you want, you wimpy little spineless maggot?
Could you train me to be better than the Swordmaster?
Better than the Swordmaster? You? You could never be half the sword fighter Carly is. Even with hours of hard work and sweat and blood. I remember fighting side by side with Carla at Port Royal. The local constabulary had us cornered. It looked like we were done for, but then she said... But I digress. You just don't have what it takes.
I do so have what it takes.
You do not.
I do so.
You do not.
I do so.
Oh, I like your spirit. I'll do what I can. Of course, it'll cost you. What do you got?
Well, I've got 30 pieces of eight.
Say no more, say no more. Let's see your sword.
Okay, check it out.
Yes, this is a nice one. Let's get to it. Okay, you maggot. Why don't you whip that sword out and let's see what you can do with it? Boy, you fight like a dairy farmer. I usually don't waste my time with vermin like yourself. But seeing as this LeChuck thing has put a cramp on business, I got no choice. I need the money. Yes, I can see this is gonna take some special measures. Just want you to know, I don't do this with everyone. It's only because I feel that special student-mentor pieces of eight bonding that I'm going to these lengths. I'm gonna put you up against the machine.
Machine? Is this gonna hurt? Yikes!
Come at me. Don't be afraid, you won't hurt me. Watch your footwork. Use your forte against the foible. Distance, distance! No! Beat first, then lunge! Advance, thrust, recover, parry, repulse! No! Beat first, then lunge!
Hours later.
You're starting to get the hang of it.
More hours later.
Not bad. You've got good form. Now I'm gonna let you in on the true secret of sword fighting. Sword fighting is kind of like making love. It's not always what you do, but what you say. Any fool pirate can swing a sharp piece of metal around and hope to cut something. But the pros, they know just when to cut their opponent with an insult. One that catches them off guard. You see, kid, your wit's gotta be twice as sharp as your sword. Let's try a couple of insults out, shall we? Okay, imagine this. We're fighting up a storm, just like Carla and I were doing at Port Royal. There's a sudden break in the fighting, and I say to you, you fight like a dairy farmer. You respond with?
Oh, yeah?
I can see we've got a lot of work to do here. You should have responded with something like, how appropriate, you fight like a cow. You see, it's razor-sharp wit like that that wins fights. Let's try another. Imagine this. You're trapped up against a wall. My sword just slashed two cuts into your face. I say, soon you'll be wearing my sword like a shish kebab. You respond with?
So's your mother.
I can see we're in deep trouble here. Ah. A correct response to, soon you'll be wearing my sword like a shish kebab, would have been something like, first, you better stop waving it around like a feather duster. See? Razor sharp. Now, I suggest you go out there and learn some insults.
I can't help but feel like I've been ripped off. I'm sure you're feeling something similar.
Dangerous to your health.
My name is Guybrush Threepwood. Prepare to die. Soon you'll be wearing my sword like a shish kebab.
First, you better stop waving it like a feather duster. People fall at my feet when they see me coming.
Oh, yeah?
My handkerchief will wipe up your blood.
Oh, yeah? I give up. You win.
Stopping a pirate can be dangerous to your health.
My name is Guybrush Threepwood. Prepare to die. My handkerchief will wipe up your blood.
I am rubber. You are glue.
People fall at my feet when they see me coming.
Even before they smell your breath? I've heard you were a contemptible sneak.
Oh, yeah?
I've spoken with apes more polite than you.
Oh, yeah? Look behind you! A three-headed monkey!
Whatcha be wantin', you scurvy lubber?
My name is Guybrush Threepwood. Prepare to die. My handkerchief will wipe up your blood.
So, you got that job as a janitor after all. I've heard you were a contemptible sneak.
Oh, yeah?
I once owned a dog that was smarter than you.
Oh, yeah? Uncle! Uncle!
Move out of the way, or I cuts my way through.
Ever notice how all these roads start to look the same?
Yeah,
Now that you mention it, they do. It's probably just that we're tired.
My name is Guybrush Threepwood. Prepare to die. I once owned a dog that was smarter than you.
He must have taught you everything you know. Soon you'll be wearing my sword like a shish kebab.
First, you'd better stop waving it like a feather duster. I've heard you were a contemptible sneak.
I'm rubber, you are glue.
I've spoken with apes more polite than you.
I'm glad to hear you attended your family reunion. People fall at my feet when they see me coming.
Even before they smell your breath?
I give up. You win.
Aye, this better be important.
My name is Guybrush Threepwood. Prepare to die. My handkerchief will wipe up your blood.
So, you got that job as janitor, after all.
You make me want to puke.
Oh, yeah?
I'm not gonna take your insolence sitting down.
Oh, yeah? Yikes, nice move.
What have you wanting, you scurvy lummer?
My name is Guybrush Threepwood. Prepare to die. I'm not gonna take your insolence sitting down.
I'm rubber, you are glue.
People fall at my feet when they see me coming.
I'm shaken.
I've spoken with apes more polite than you.
I'm shaken. I give up. You win.
Stopping a pirate can be dangerous to your health.
My name is Guybrush Threepwood. Prepare to die. I'm not gonna take your insolence sitting down.
Oh, your hemorrhoids are flaring up again, eh? There are no words for how disgusting you are.
I'm shaken.
You fight like a dairy farmer.
How appropriate. You fight like a cow. People fall at my feet when they see me coming.
Even before they smell your breath?
Yikes, nice move.
What you be wanting, you scurvy lubber?
My name is Guybrush Threepwood. Prepare to die. There are no words for how disgusting you are.
I'm shaking.
I've heard you were a contemptible sneak.
I'm shaking.
I've spoken with apes more polite than you.
I'm shaking. Wow, you're good enough to fight the Sword Master.
Whatever you wantin', you scurvy lubber?
My name is Guybrush Threepwood. Prepare to die. There are no words for how disgusting you are.
Yes, there are. You just never learned them. You have the manners of a beggar.
I am rubber, you are glue.
You're no match for my brains, you poor fool.
Oh, yeah? Yikes, nice move.
Aye, this better be important.
My name is Guybrush Threepwood. Prepare to die. You're no match for my brains, you poor fool.
I'd be in real trouble if you ever used them. I once owned a dog that was smarter than you.
He must have taught you everything you know. Have the manners of a beggar.
I wanted to make sure you'd feel comfortable with me. Nobody's ever drawn blood from me, and nobody ever will.
Oh, yeah? Uncle!
Stopping a pirate can be dangerous to your health.
My name is Guybrush Threepwood. Prepare to die. Nobody's ever drawn blood from me, and nobody ever will.
Oh, yeah?
You're no match for my brains, you poor fool.
I'd be in real trouble if you ever used them. I once owned a dog that was smarter than you.
He must have taught you everything you know. You fight like a dairy farmer.
I am rubber, you are glue. Wow! You're good enough to fight the Sword Master!
Aye, this better be important.
My name is Guybrush Threepwood. Prepare to die. Nobody's ever drawn blood from me, and nobody ever will.
You run that fast? You fight like a dairy farmer.
How appropriate. You fight like a cow. You're no match for my brains, you poor fool.
I'd be in real trouble if you ever used them. My handkerchief will wipe up your blood.
So you got that job as a janitor after all. have the manners of a beggar.
I wanted to make sure you'd feel comfortable with me.
I give up. You win.
What you be wanting, you scurvy lover?
My name is Guybrush Threepwood. Prepare to die.
Oh, you make me want to puke.
You make me think somebody already did. Nobody's ever drawn blood from me, and nobody ever will.
You run that fast? You're no match for my brains, you poor fool.
I'd be in real trouble if you ever used them. Soon you'll be wearing my sword like a shish kebab.
First, you'd better stop waving it like a feather duster. I've heard you were a contemptible sneak.
Too bad no one's ever heard of you at all.
Uncle! Uncle!
Stopping a pirate can be dangerous to your health.
My name is Guybrush Threepwood. Prepare to die.
Oh, you make me want to puke.
You make me think somebody already did. You're no match for my brains, you poor fool.
I'd be in real trouble if you ever used them. Nobody's ever drawn blood from me, and nobody ever will.
I'm shaking, I'm shaking.
I once owned a dog that was smarter than you.
They must have taught you everything you know. This is the end for you, you gutter-crawling cur!
Oh, yeah? I give up! You win!
Aye, this better be important.
My name is Guybrush Threepwood. Prepare to die. This is the end for you, you gutter-crawling cur.
Oh, yeah?
I once owned a dog that was smarter than you.
He must have taught you everything you know. You're no match for my brains, you poor fool.
I'd be in real trouble if you ever used them. Nobody's ever drawn blood from me, and nobody ever will.
I'm rubber, you are glue. Wow, you're good enough to fight the sword, master.
Move out of the way, or I cuts my way through.
My name is Guybrush Threepwood. Prepare to die. This is the end for you, you gutter-crawling cur.
And I've got a little tip for you. Get the point? You have the manners of a beggar.
I wanted to make sure you'd feel comfortable with me. People fall at my feet when they see me coming.
Even before they smell your breath? I'm not gonna take your insolence sitting down.
Your hemorrhoids are flaring up again, huh? There are no words for how disgusting you are.
Yes, there are. You just never learned them.
Look behind you! A three-headed monkey!
How dare you approach the Swordmaster without permission, which I surely didn't give you.
My name is Guybrush Threepwood. I've come to kill you.
Nothing like being honest. I can tell by the sarcastic expression on your face that you've been fully trained by Captain Smirk. Let's get this over with. My name is feared in every dirty corner of this island.
So you got that job as a janitor after all.
My tongue is sharper than any sword.
And I've got a little tip for you. Get the point?
My last fight ended with my hands covered with blood.
Oh, yeah?
Now I know what filth and stupidity really are.
I wanted to make sure you'd feel comfortable with me.
I will milk every drop of blood from your body.
How appropriate! You fight like a cow!
Every word you say to me is stupid.
I wanted to make sure you'd feel comfortable with me.
No one will ever catch me fighting as badly as you do.
You run that fast?
There are no clever moves that can help you now.
Yes, there are. You just never learned them.
I give up. You win. Well, I hope you're happy. You can go back and brag to all your friends about how you beat the Swordmaster. You'll need proof here. This should convince them.
So confused.
Hey, what are you doing just standing around? The governor's been kidnapped.
What? By whom?
LeChuck's got her on that ship that just sailed off. I'm afraid we've seen the last of her.
So where were you this whole time? Sleeping?
Hey, I'm a lookout, not a bodyguard.
Where did they go?
LeChuck's taken the governor back to his hideout on Monkey Island. I'm afraid that no pirate on this island is brave enough to follow him there. But hey, good luck. Oh yeah, I almost forgot. They left this note. You can have it, but I don't think you'll like what it says.
Attention, pirates of Melee. Your governor is alive and well and by my side as she was always meant to be. If you try to find us, you will only meet with horrifying disaster. Yours truly, Captain LeChuck.
Cody. I'm Stan of Stan's previously owned vessels, and I'd stand on my head to make you a deal. What sort of craft are you looking for? Big? Fast? Slow? You want it? I got it. And if I don't got it, I'll get it. I want to make you a deal that you're happy with. Because if you're not happy, I'm not happy. But I know you're going to leave here happy today. How do I know? Just look at all these ships. I've got something for everyone. Come, take a look around. So tell me, what are you interested in looking at today?
Let me see the best ship you've got.
Hey, it's nice to meet a man who appreciates quality. I've got just the boat for you. Walk this way. Now this is a ship fit for a king. I mean, we're talking 15 staterooms, a fireplace in every one. We're talking two pools, one indoor, one outdoor. We're talking rotating ballroom. We're talking heated crow's nest. We're talking 200 feet of ocean-going decadence. And all for one low price. Speaking of price, how much would you like to spend?
Actually, I was hoping to get one on credit.
Sorry, kid. Neither a borrower nor a lender be. That's just old Stan's philosophy. If you've got a job, the storekeeper in town might extend you some credit. Then we'd have something to talk about. Unless, of course, you've already got some other means of financing.
On second thought, this may not be the ship for me.
Okay, but I tell you, I got a feeling you're gonna leave here today with a new, previously owned vessel. So, what else can I show you?
Actually, I'd like to go think about it some more.
Sure, think it over. I don't want you to feel pressured or anything. Bye now. I forgot to give you my card. And here's something else to remember me by.
A compass?
An extra strong magnetic compass.
With your picture on it.
That's right. It always points directly back here. So if you're looking for a good deal, you know where to go. I'll be right here when you come back. But I can't guarantee that any of these ships will.
Right.
They're moving fast today. Yes, sirree. Can't hardly keep anything in stock. He'll be back.
You've already got the t-shirt. What do you want now?
The governor's been kidnapped!
What? That's ridiculous. Oh, no. This looks bad. Very bad.
I'm getting a ship and a crew together to go rescue her.
I have a feeling I'm going to regret this, but count me in. I'll meet you at the dock.
Meanwhile, having just returned from Melee, LeChuck and his crew find their old hiding place in the underground rivers of Monkey Island and drop anchor.
Captain, sir, I just stopped by to congratulate you on your kidnapping mission. Captain? Captain, are you all right?
Thank you.
never felt better. And how fares our prisoner?
Ah, yes, the prisoner. We had a little trouble.
Trouble?
No, nothing to worry about, sir. Everything's under control. She escaped a few times, but we've got her locked up in the brig. No one's getting in or out of there.
For your sake, I hope not. With years of planning almost destroyed by my death, I'm not taking any chances now.
You took care of Mr. Threepwood then?
Guybrush Threepwood will not be a problem. At this very moment, he's 20 feet underwater. Probably bloated up like a fattened pig. His eyes being eaten out by crabs. Fish pecking at his fingers. Kinda makes you wish you were there to watch.
Ah, yes, sir. Ugh, sure does at that.
Now, go check on the root. Make sure it's locked up tight.
Aye, aye, Captain.
Hey! I don't like visitors. Who are you?
I'm a pirate, Cannonballhead. Who are you?
My name's Meathook, and I think you've got a little attitude problem.
Well, I think you've got a little hair problem.
Jeez! You just don't know when to quit, do you?
I'm sorry, I was just trying to be funny.
You want to say something funny? Ha ha! Watch this. Say hello, Roger.
Hello, Roger.
Ha 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 ha! Pretty good, eh? I got a whole routine, but I don't have the time to do it all right now. Maybe if we're ever on a long ocean voyage together. But until then, I'm a very busy man, so...
The governor's been kidnapped!
What? That's preposterous.
Oh, really? Take a look at this note they left.
Oh, no. This is horrible! What are we going to do?
We could get a crew together and sail off after them.
What an idea! Now, if we only had a captain...
Well, what about me?
Ha! You! That's a good one.
Hey, I'm serious.
Really?
Really?
Okay, let's see you prove it. Walk this way. There's something in here that I want to show you. Something horrible. Something so horrible that I stay awake at night just thinking about it. But I don't mean to scare you. I'm sure a big brave guy like yourself will have no problem facing this monster. After all, it's much smaller than the beast that bit off my hands so many years ago. Arr, 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 arr. Let's just hope you're quicker than I was. Oh, I just remembered something. I never did get around to feeding him this week. Ha 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 ha! Silly me! I'll let you open this last door yourself. Just let me get out of your way.
Wait.
Getting cold feet?
No, I just don't know what I'm supposed to do.
You're supposed to open that little door. And if you're brave enough, touch the beast inside.
Oh, is that all?
Okay, go ahead. If you've got the guts. I don't believe it. You are a brave man after all. You faced the beast I've feared all these years. You had the guts to do what I never could. I feel like such a coward. I'm not good enough to be on your crew. I'm not even good enough to swab your decks.
Oh, come on, Meathook. You're a big, strong, good-looking guy with a talking tattoo. You can swab my decks anytime.
Really?
Sure.
I can still be on your crew.
Just pack your stuff and meet me at the dock.
Oh, thank you. Thank you. I won't let you down. Hey, maybe I'll get a chance to show you my whole tattoo routine when we're at sea.
Wow, this is sounding better and better all the time. Wow, it works both ways. That's some chicken. I'll save you, Elaine. I promise. This stuff is eating right through the mug.
Gray, a drink. I'm real thirsty. Yikes! Wow, and to think I used to drink that stuff. I'm free! Oh yeah,
Thanks. My name's Otis, by the way. If there's anything I can ever do for you.
Well, actually, there is something. I'm looking for brave people to join my crew and sail off to Monkey Island with me to rescue the governor. She's been abducted by the fearsome pirate LeChuck and is being held against her will somewhere in his secret hideout.
I see. Well, yes, LeChuck, you say? Well, yes.
Yes, of course. We must sail to Monkey Island and...
Hey, look behind you! A three-headed monkey!
I can't believe I fell for that. Pretty good trick, though.
Oh, I should have known it'd be you again. The Swordmaster says you can jump in the lake, by the way. What do you want?
I'm interested in procuring a note of credit.
You are? You got a job?
Yes, of course I do.
All right. I'll get one of my notes and we'll fill it out. Let's see here. What did you say your occupation was?
I'm a grog-swilling, foul-smelling pirate.
Foul-smelling, yes. Grog-swilling, maybe. But a pirate? Don't make me laugh. Come back when you got some tattoos, or a peg leg, or at least an eye patch, for crying out loud. What else do you want?
I'm looking for the Swordmaster of Melee Island.
Look, I told you she doesn't want to see you.
Maybe if you asked her again?
I guess I could hike all the way over there. Again. Be right back. And don't touch anything!
There's nothing in here but this note. I, the good and honorable storekeeper, do hereby take liability for the debts of the bearer of this note for any amount up to 5,000 pieces of 8.
Hey, don't mess with my rat. I said don't pester the rat. I'm not gonna warn you again. Leave the rat alone. Hey, man. Frank, make him quit it. Oh, now look what you did.
Bobby. Great to see you again. I knew you'd come back. Everybody does. You know why they come back? Just look at all these ships. I've got something for everyone. Come, take a look around. So, what else can I show you?
I don't really have that much to spend.
Have no fear. Every ship I sell is a bargain. But if you're looking for a real steal, I've got just the boat for you. Walk this way. This here is the famous Sea Monkey. The only ship ever to make it to Monkey Island and come back with anyone aboard left alive. Or should I say, anything. You see, the previous owners of this ship were two adventurous pirates. They set off, like many before, to find the legendary secret of Monkey Island. And like many before, they disappeared forever. Their fate? A mystery. Almost as mysterious as how this ship returned to Malay Island without a single human aboard. Some claim it was sailed back by a crew of chimps.
Chimps? There aren't any chimps in the Caribbean.
Oh, shut up. It makes a good story. Anyway, this baby's mine now. That is, until someone makes me an offer. Just how much were you looking to spend today?
I got credit from the storekeeper. Will you take it?
Hey, of course. Your credit's always good at Stan's. It doesn't matter if you've had credit problems in the past. Divorce, chronic gambling mishaps. I mean, who am I to judge, right? If the storekeeper trusts you enough to give you a letter of credit, then you must be an honest man with a steady income, right?
Right.
Let's get down to brass tacks, shall we? I know you want it. You know you want it. And I know that I want to sell it. So,
let's talk extras.
Extras? You want to talk extras? Great! This baby's loaded with extras. For instance, did I tell you about the porthole defoggers?
I think I can live without that particular piece of junk.
Okay, but don't blame me if you run into an iceberg or something. But wait, there's more. Did I tell you about the anti-lock anchor?
I think I can live without that particular piece of junk.
Sure, throw safety to the wind. But wait, there's more. Did I tell you about the rack and pinion rudder?
I think I can live without that particular piece of junk.
Well, I guess it'll float without it, barely. But wait, there's more. Did I tell you about the velour sail covers?
I think I can live without that particular piece of junk.
Hey, travel light. I can understand that, sure. Of course, mutiny is an ugly word. But wait, there's more. Did I tell you about the tachometer?
I think I can live without that particular piece of junk.
Wow, does your wife know you're such a cheapskate? But wait, there's more. Did I tell you about the elevator made with wood from Burgundy wine casks?
I think I can live without that particular piece of junk.
Yeah, I guess that is kind of decadent, isn't it? But wait, there's more. Did I tell you about this simulated wood siding?
I think I can live without that particular piece of junk.
Okay, but I'm telling you, barnacles hate simulated wood. But wait, there's more. Did I tell you about the porthole defoggers?
Enough about extras already.
Okay, where were we?
I'd like to make you an offer.
Great. How much?
I'd like to pay 2,000 pieces of eight.
Sure, I guess we can start out at the bottom. I got all day. I'm going to be getting a whole new shipment next week, so you got me over a barrel. I've got to sell this baby, even if it means losing my shirt.
I'd like to make you an offer.
Great. How much?
Well, how does 3,000 pieces of eight sound?
That's a little bit more like it, but not much. I know you can try harder than that. Just tell me, what would it take to get you to sail this ship away today?
I'd like to make you an offer.
Great. How much?
Okay, 4,000 pieces of eight.
That's a little bit more like it, but not much. I know you can try harder than that. You realize, don't you, that they just don't make them like this anymore?
Forget it. I don't need this boat anyway.
Now wait a second. Don't go away mad. I'm sure we can work something out.
Well, maybe you're right.
Of course I am. Now, where were we? Oh, yeah. Buddy, you can tell me the truth. It's the little woman, isn't it? You're afraid of what she'll say when you come home with a new ship. Don't be such a wimp. Stand up to her. She'll respect you for it. And when she sees this ship, she'll love you for it. Trust me.
I'd like to make you an offer.
Great. How much?
All right, 5,000, but that's my final offer.
5,000 pieces of eight? Okay. It's killing me, but okay. And I thought I was gonna give my children Christmas presents this year. Just take it out of here. I'm glad to get rid of it. Oh, yeah. Do you have that note from the storekeeper on you? Thanks. I've got to run these numbers by my boss. He'll think I'm nuts, but I'll talk him into it. You meet me at the dock with your crew. I'll bring the ship and the papers. I just want to say that I really feel like we got to know each other today. I mean, I really felt some bonding here. And I don't just say that to everybody. It's been great doing business with you. Really. Sucker. See you at the dock, and don't forget your crew. All three of them. It's a good thing you showed up. 10 people have offered to buy this baby off me while I've been standing here waiting for you. But I said, no way. I know a guy who's in love with this ship, and it would break his heart to lose it. Am I right? Of course I am. I mean, just look at her. Sleek, aerodynamic, a buoyant barnacle-covered beauty. I think we're having a real moment here. I've changed my mind. I can't give her up. You can have your money back. How could I sell something so dear? Then again, a deal's a deal, right? Right. Good luck, yeah. I'm out of here. Whoops, I almost forgot to give you this free seafaring literature. My gift to you. Just remember where you got it. Stands!
Maybe I should have gotten that extended warranty after all.
Hey, long time no see.
Otis, I thought I'd never see you again.
Hey, I could never pass up a chance to make some easy money.
Money?
Yeah, we are getting paid for this, right?
How appropriate. You fight like a cow.
You never did know when to use that one. So what's that waterlogged wreck doing out there? How are we gonna get our ship in here with that pile of scrap in the way?
Where's the cabin boy? I need him to go back to my place and pick up my bags.
What's going on here?
Where's our ship?
Where's our crew?
This isn't gonna be as easy as I thought.
through the courageous leadership of Captain Threepwood, the Sea Monkey is finally underway. Undaunted by their lack of navigational equipment or expertise, the crew begins to plan their voyage.
First of all, I'd like to say it's great to be working with such a fine crew. The voyage ahead is not going to be easy. It's going to take skill, endurance, and most of all, teamwork. First, I thought we'd assign some duties.
What is it we were suckered into doing again?
I made a list.
Suckered is right.
I don't see what the big deal is with rescuing the governor. She can clearly take care of herself. The way I look at it, we got this great ship. Well, we got a ship. Why don't we kick back, tie a rope to the wheel, and cruise for a while? I could use a little work on my tan.
Come to think of it, I have been a little stressed out lately. I could use a rest.
Then it's decided. We cruise the Caribbean.
I'm doomed. There's an old dusty book inside. Let's see what it is. It says, Captain's Log, March 10th. First Mate Toothrot and I have been searching for Monkey Island for over a month with no success. The directions we purchased on Melee proved to be a recipe, not a map as we had believed. Captain's Log, March 12th. I wish Toothrot would take a bath. Captain's Log, March 17th. I wish Toothrot would stop snoring. Captain's Log, March 23rd. Toothrot is really starting to get on my nerves. I figure it's only a matter of time before we come to blows. Captain's Log, April 2nd. As a gesture to restore our friendship, Toothrot offered to fix dinner tonight. Captain's Log, April 3rd. I don't know how we did it, but we've arrived at Monkey Island. Both Toothrot and I passed out from the soup he fixed last night. When we awoke, Monkey Island was sitting off the bow. Captain's Log, April 4th. Toothrot and I filled the rowboat with supplies and are ready to set out to Monkey Island. We are both excited at the prospect of being the first civilized people to learn the secret of Monkey Island. Captain's Log, April 5th. We had to turn around and return to the ship. Toothrot forgot to go to the bathroom before we left. We'll set out again tomorrow. And that's the last entry. Inside. This is no prize. It's a small key with a finely engraved monkey on it. Man, that's heavy. Filled, no doubt, with golden jewels. Hey, look, a piece of paper. And some cinnamon sticks.
Directions to Monkey Island. Preheat pot to 450 degrees. Add the following ingredients. 1 cinnamon stick, 4 leaves of mint, 1 human skull, pressed, 1 squirt squid ink, 2 pints monkey blood, 1 live chicken, 3 ounces brimstone, 1 or more of the following: pyridoxine hydrochloride, zinc oxide, yellow 8, mine mononitrate, and BHA. Let bubble over a low flame until thickened. Serves crew of 4.
There's some very fine wine in here.
I'll grab it.
Wow, gunpowder! I think I'll take some.
That should be enough. I think I have enough fiber. I'll just hold on to this.
This is gonna be good.
About time I got rid of this worthless artifact. Good thing I've got a million of these.
Just a drop. I love cinnamon.
Yikes! Oh, I think I'm getting dizzy.
Overcome by the fumes and stench, Guybrush quickly loses consciousness. Moments later, the voodoo spell kicks in, turning the ship to an unknown heading and off on its mysterious voyage. Days pass.
Oh, I feel awful.
I'll take some more.
Holy monkey bladders! It's Monkey Island!
Deja vu. It's much too dangerous to climb out there for no reason.
I'm Herman Toothrot. Don't bother to say hello. I've only been waiting 20 years to talk to somebody civilized. I don't mind. Fine. By the way, you might want to think about putting out that fire. Someone could be hurt.
Notice of public meeting. There will be a meeting Wednesday evening to discuss the recent occupation of the sacred monkey head by the ghost pirate LeChuck, and the subsequent impact on the environment and the tourist trade. All Monkey Island cannibals are encouraged to attend. Here.
it sure is hot here. I'll check out this note while I'm at it. It's printed on letterhead. To the ghost pirate LeChuck, we must ask you once again to curtail your nightly activities in the sacred monkey head area. Decent people are trying to sleep. Kindly keep the noise level down. The Monkey Island Cannibals. P.S. We saw you taking that woman with the scarf down there. To the Monkey Island Cannibals, please stop moving this. It is delicately balanced. Herman Toothrot. I can see that big banana tree on the beach. Tree.
Ah, I never get tired of this view, even if I have been looking at it for 20 years now. Even if it is the only view on the island.
Yes, it is a nice view.
I'm afraid I must be going now. Pressing business, you know.
Like it hit the big banana tree on the beach. I bet the odds against that are incredible. Mr. Toothrot, please remove this dangerous object. Lemonhead knocked a rock onto it from the cliff above and nearly sank a passing ship. The Cannibals. Boy, it sure is hot here.
This is an old friend of mine, the one I sailed here with. He's lost weight. Never looked better.
What happened to him?
Oh, nasty accident. He was trying to put up a swing.
Are you some kind of a castaway?
What do I look like? The caretaker? Listen to this guy. Am I some kind of castaway?
I thought this island was uninhabited.
Well, you thought wrong. My name's Toothrot. Herman Toothrot. I live here. Well, not right here. In the fort on the volcano.
Were you stranded?
You think I stay here for my health? Woohoo, boy!
To the Monkey Island Cannibals. I don't mind you worshipping in front of the sacred monkey idol, which doubles as my home and secret base of operations, but could you please refrain from leaving messy sacrifices on my porch? Also, please do not enter the monkey head. G.P. LeChuck. I can paddle it with these oars. Herman, please return our key to the monkey head, the cannibals.
Is that a banana in your pocket, or are you just glad to see us?
You've got a lot of nerve stealing from the notorious Monkey Island cannibals.
You're cannibals?
Well, yes. Although lately, we've been trying to stay away from red meat.
Only for health reasons. We're still as vicious as ever.
Oh, especially with tourists who try to steal our stuff for souvenirs. Well, what do you have to say for yourself?
Oh, go ahead and eat me. See if I care.
Hey, whatever you say. We might eat you, we might let you go. We'll have to talk about it with the village nutritionist. Come, let me show you our guest hunt. That should do it.
I might fit through that hole, but I don't think this banana picker will.
And no, I'm not getting squeamish. I'd love to eat the guy.
So let's do it.
But think of your arteries.
We are cannibals, for crying out loud.
Yeah. The cannibals have to watch their saturated fats just like everyone else.
There's a message in it. It's a memo. To Herman Toothrot, from Yammer, Hem, and Haw, attorneys at law, regarding suit against cannibal tribe over malicious tossing of your oars into a chasm. I think we have a case here. We can probably soak them for emotional distress and possibly punitive damages as well.
Sounds like legalese. I don't think I can translate the rest.
Yipes. Shish kebab. You won't go that way. I doubt anyone will miss this piece of junk.
The banana thief returns to the scene of the crime.
Maybe we should just eat him right now.
Do you have any idea how much cholesterol is in one of these things? Now then, how did you break out of our hut, and why did you come back?
Don't eat me. I'll give you anything.
Anything? If you had some sort of offering for us, something that we could pass on to the great monkey?
Well,
hey, wow, this is impressive. Lemonhead, take a look at this.
Ooh, that's nice. And it says, made by Lemonhead, just like one of mine. We should take this to the great monkey.
Yes, I agree. We are very grateful to you for this fine gift. If there's anything you need on Monkey Island, just come see us.
All I want is my banana picker back. I was just looking for the natives to get them to return my banana picker, but I can't seem to find them.
I have your banana picker.
Hey, thanks. I thought I'd never see this again. Here, you can take this key to the monkey head back to the natives.
Okay. And don't worry, I won't use it or anything. What happened to your pants?
What pants?
Excuse me, I've got some pressing business to attend to.
Yes, me too.
Have you come back to let us repay you for your fine gift?
Well, actually, there is something.
Tell us, what is it?
I'm looking for somebody.
Here? On Monkey Island?
We're the only people living on Monkey Island.
Well, the only civilized people.
That's okay. The people I'm looking for aren't living.
Oh, yeah. Those guys.
Then you've seen the ghost pirate LeChuck and his cadaverous crew?
Those jerks have been bugging us for months.
Zooming around here in that creepy ghost ship of theirs, wailing and moaning until all hours of the morning.
Scaring away all the cruise ship business?
Normally, when we have problems with the undead, we just cook up our standard potion of exorcism and be done with it.
So why don't you do that now?
Well,
The main ingredient of the potion is a very rare root. In fact, there's only one in existence.
We only use a little bit at a time, you see.
But LeChuck stole the whole thing.
Where is he hiding it?
He's in a place beneath this island, somewhere in a huge system of catacombs. A hellish place filled with the wailing of tortured souls trapped forever in the rock, where the walls bleed and the air is thick with the rancid smell of pure evil.
Tourists used to line up for hours to see it.
And then LeChuck came and ruined everything, right?
No, we lost the key.
It was stolen.
Well, we loaned it to a hermit who lives on the island.
And until that crusty old pantless weirdo brings it back, we're keeping his banana picker.
I'm off to find LeChuck and get the root.
Sorry, but it's just not that easy. Trying to find LeChuck could be very dangerous.
You'd never find your way through the catacombs without them.
Hey, ixnay on the edhe of the Avigator Nay.
The what?
Nothing.
Nothing.
Oh, come on, tell me. I gave you the idol.
It is a very nice idol.
We could at least tell him what the head does.
Well, it's a navigating tool.
It's a head. It was once attached to a navigator.
We've kept it alive magically, so we could take advantage of its innate sense of direction. Getting through the catacombs without it is impossible.
But it's our only one, so you can't have it.
I guess we have nothing to offer you.
After he gave us that nice idol, too.
Feel free to come to the Great Monkey and visit your idol anytime. So, anyway, Lemonhead, what was that you were saying about tropical oils?
Well,
it's called How to Get Ahead in Navigating.
Well, look at this. It looks like instructions on how to get ahead.
We could give him our head and use these instructions to get ourselves a new one.
Yes, I suppose we can give you this now.
Thanks.
Looks pretty good for a dried up old head, doesn't it?
We keep it wrapped in this magical necklace that makes it invisible to ghosts.
Oh, look! I think he likes you.
Just follow his nose, and he'll lead you to LeChuck's hideout in the catacombs. Then, get the root from LeChuck and come back here. We'll mix up a batch of our special enzymatic ghost-dissolving solution.
And you can pour it on LeChuck like salt on a slug.
Yeah.
Good luck!
Wait.
What?
I don't even know where the entrance to the catacombs is.
Oh, yeah. It's the big monkey head on the east side. You can't miss it. Have fun!
I had a feeling that in hell, there would be mushrooms. think it wants me to go to the left.
Okay, we're here. Now what do you want from me?
May I please have that necklace?
No, but thanks for asking so politely.
Oh, come on, please.
You can beg all you want, but you can't have it.
Pretty please?
You can beg all you want, but you can't have it.
Pretty please?
You can beg all you want, but you can't have it.
Pretty please with sugar on top?
Oh, all right, you big baby. You can have it. Hey, what good's a necklace if you don't have shoulders?
This feels weird.
The wind makes not such a creaking. Must be the wind.
Ha 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 ha!
It's all over my hands.
What was that?
Oh, good. More inventory. This should do it. Just grab this old root and be on my way.
A long walk, a brief row, and a short hike later.
I did it! I got the root!
Wow! Look, he's not kidding! Here it is!
He's not such a wimp after all!
Come on, let's go make the brew of the fermented root. Wait here, we'll be right back.
I'd love to have you stuck. I'd make a fortune.
There it is.
One squirt of that stuff and the ectoplasm really hits the fan.
And if you have any left over, it's delicious with a little vanilla ice cream. Good luck.
Thanks.
After some more furious paddling.
Eep! You scared me half to death!
What happened to the ship?
They all left for the wedding.
What wedding?
LeChuck is marrying the governor of Melee Island.
What? But how will they... Where's the wedding?
There's a lovely church on Melee Island. They're headed there.
Melee Island? Oh no. I've got to go after them. I've got to stop that wedding.
Bye.
Oh, there you are.
We've been looking all over for you. Bob!
Hi, Bob.
Hi, guys.
See, Bob. You're looking a little pale.
Well, naturally I'm pale. I am dead, after all.
Dead? How did that happen?
Oh, the usual way. Out for a day's plunder, ghost ship shows up, LeChuck kills everybody on the crew, and then signs us up on his ship. You know.
Gee, that's too bad. Maybe you'd like to join us on our quest for the perfect tan.
Well, that'd be nice, but I am trying to catch a ride to a wedding on Melee Island.
You guys know this shambling see-through shade? The one with the slippery grip on his head?
Sure. He's an old pirating buddy. I say we give him a lift.
Thanks, Otis.
We've got to get back to Melee Island.
No kidding.
Yeah, we're out of sunscreen.
Come on, let's go.
Well, that certainly was easier than the trip to Monkey Island. Wish those guys hadn't been so excited about getting sunscreen.
Now I'll have to stop the wedding by myself. Yikes.
Hey! Wait a second!
Could I interest you in some root beer, sir?
Root beer? Oh, boy! I love root beer!
Cool.
There'll be any man with reason that these two people should not be united in blissful matrimony. Let him speak now or forever hold his peace.
Elaine!
Hey! Who's that?
You!
Take this, you vaporous voodoo vermin!
Take what? Are you trying to bribe me?
Governor!
Governor!
Governor?
What's going on?
Oh, Guybrush, you mad fool! I'm impressed you came to rescue me, but it really wasn't necessary. I had everything well in hand. Unfortunately, your arrival has made it necessary for me to tip my hand early.
How? Who? But what?
How did you manage to escape?
Oh, that was easy. LeChucky's a bozo.
Hey!
And lots of his crew members were friends of mine when they were alive.
I thought LeChuck was going to marry you.
Yes, so did I.
Yes, so did he. But I arranged for a little surprise when it came time to kiss the bride.
If you're here, then who's that in the dress? What?
Then don't scare them! They have my ghost sack and root beer bottle!
Oh, I'll get it!
Oops.
Ugh, nice going, Guybrush. Now I've got to chase them down to get my voodoo root beer back.
But I... Hey!
You dared come here and confront me? I can't believe your audacity.
Well, I can't believe your stupidity.
Yeah? Well, I can't believe your frivolity.
I can't believe your atrocity.
Yeah? Well, I can't believe your mobility.
Well, I can't believe your virility.
Yeah? Well, I can't believe your fragility.
Well, I can't believe your validity.
Ah, I grow tired of you.
Say now, let's not be hasty.
To see you, son. How's the ship? If you're interested in trading up, I can give you a fair price for it. Howdy, partner. You know, just by looking at you, I can tell you're a man of the world. A man with an eye for quality. A man who knows a good bargain when he...
Thank you.
Yikes!
Oh, don't sneak up on me like that.
Sorry.
That's okay. You know, LeChuck was a deviant, obnoxious, slithery, creepy, crawly sort of a guy, but I'll say one thing for him.
What's that?
He sure looks nice exploding against the night sky.
Yes, it's very romantic. Can I buy you a root beer?
Sure. There's more at Stan's. Oh gosh, I hope Stan's okay. You know, I completely forgot about Herman Toothrot.
Now I wonder where my pirate friend has got to. I certainly hope he didn't leave without me.
Yeah, at least I learned something from all this.
What's that?
How to deal with frustration, disappointment, and irritating cynicism.
That sounds like something my husband would say.
Ah.
Bye-bye.